Hey everyone, so this is part one of our three-part series on data visualization for your research manuscript. If you're working on your manuscript and you're starting to plan your figures and tables and charts, definitely check out the entire series. In this video, I'll just be talking about how to determine whether to use a chart or a table to present information. I'll also talk about general guidelines on preparing figures, managing captions, preparing tables, and preparing lists. So let's get started. The first thing we'll talk about here is determining whether to choose a chart or a table to convey your information. Unfortunately, there are some really quick guidelines on deciding between which way to present your info. So you'd use graphs or charts to visualize trends and relationships, use graphs or charts to present statistical information, and you want to use tables for precise numbers or for easy lookup values. You can also use a table to help show your experimental setup. One thing is to avoid using a table if just one or two sentences could clearly present the same information. No matter which way you choose, you want to make sure you keep your reader in mind by presenting information in a simple, easy to understand way and presenting it where in your paper your reader would expect to find it. Before going over some of the general guidelines for preparing your figures, I do want to encourage you to look up your Journal of Interests guidelines to make sure that things you're planning would comply. Once you're familiar with your journal's requirements, then you want to make sure you're presenting your figures with the following standards. Figures must be discussed by name in the main text of your paper, so you can't just have a figure without the body of your paper giving it context and calling it out specifically. Next, the first letter in the word figure should be capitalized. Figures are placed and numbered sequentially, so you would have figure 1, figure 2, figure 3, and so on. Use sequential letters to label multiple figures within a figure set. So in this illustration here, you can see the figure is named figure 1 and it contains multiple images with sequential letters, each pointing to the specific image within the set. The figure label appears at the bottom of your figure. So again, in this example, figure 1 shows up beneath your image. And finally, a figure should always be followed by a brief descriptive caption. You can see the caption here, and the caption also calls out each sequential letter, describing it in more detail. Figures are not only graphs and charts and photos, they can also be presented as illustrations to clearly help the reader understand more information. Another thing to keep in mind when presenting your figures is to keep them proportional in your paper, so no skewing or stretching, all proportional. Okay, so let's talk really quickly about captions here. Captions help the reader better understand the figures that are being presented. Some things to remember when writing your captions for your figures is that they're not typically presented as complete sentences, yet they are punctuated. And you can use complete sentences if more information is absolutely needed, so that is possible. Tables are the next really common visual addition for your paper. As mentioned before, tables are great for presenting precise numbers when that information is most important. They also help the reader quickly compare information, and tables can show like the presence or absence of something, and they can also show how you organized a specific setup for your experiment. So they're super helpful. Just like figures, tables should summarize the information rather than repeat what's being said in the text. Really, the text in the body of your paper should help give the reader more context to your tables and figures. So when it comes to preparing and labeling your tables, here are some general guidelines, and again, consult your journal for their requirements as well. Tables must be directly discussed within the body of your paper, so it's called out. The T in table must be capitalized and it's followed by a number. Tables are numbered sequentially, so you'd have table 1, table 2, table 3, and so on. Table titles are presented above the table. So in this example, you can see where the table labels are table 1 and then its title. Tables should have a descriptive title. Table columns must have descriptive, meaningful headlines. And you want to present your table as simply and clearly as possible. So going back to this table one example, the title is Tomato Variant Germination at Different Temperatures. There are meaningful headers showing planting temperatures and tomato variety. And this table is an example of presenting the presence of or absence of something. So in this case, it was the observation or non-observation of germination. The last thing I want to talk about is lists. They aren't nearly as common, but they are good to talk about because lists can also really help the reader understand information you're presenting in your manuscript. Just a quick note, lists are kind of in their own category. They aren't considered tables and they're not really figures either. When creating your list for your manuscript, again, check with your journal guidelines. Not all journals permit lists. Generally, your list should have information arranged alphabetically, that is, unless there's reason to have it arranged in a different order, and your list should have an unnumbered title to it. So that's the basics of figures and tables and lists. I think the big takeaways are consult your journal guidelines and just kind of familiarize yourself with the standards. As you're preparing your manuscript, you might want to check out the other videos we have on data visualization, and also we have a writing handbook with a ton more information. I have it linked below. It's also free to download, so check it out. If you found this video helpful, hit that like button. That helps us out, and definitely subscribe for more content. Be sure to check out goldbio.com to find high-quality reagents and ton more resources there, and thank you all for watching. Good luck with the manuscript.